our humanity. Humanity. All right, so I'm natural, meaning my metabolism, my genetics, basically everything is, I'd say God-given, but God didn't give me this, my parents did. So I'm a genetic outlier, and I basically don't really need to take anything because anytime I work out, I have very high, like my libido and all my test levels are through the roof naturally. So I just, like right now, I'm pumped. I'm not on anything. Like, I drink coffee. And yes, I believe that TRT and all that shit is considered being on something. Not like, oh, if it's below 200, it's not, I'm still natty. No, you're not. If you're injecting shit into you, you're not fucking natural. It's synthetic. So, to answer your question, trenbolone, or TRIN, as they like to call it online, is basically was first introduced in Japan or China, I'm not sure which country, and it was used to inject cows to make them bigger, so their meat, they have more meat basically to use and sell. So now when you see guys that are like heavyweights that are just fucking like walking clouds, they're taking TREN, which literally just boom. It's trenbolone, which increases your size, and also HGH, which is human growth hormone, which basically those are the guys that have like bigger heads. Like Joe Rogan's head got bigger. Yeah, he was on HGH. Openly admits it. But that's basically what it is. The bigger guys are either going to be running like 600 test, which is testosterone, or they'll be on trenbolone, and then they fucking start putting Primo in, which is another injectable. And then they're like, and then all the, usually when it comes to physiques, like for me, if I was to compete, I would probably take Anavar or Dynabol. Just to get a little bigger, the Dynabol gives you water retention, and Anavar basically makes you like ultra shredded. So like if you took like 40 milligrams of Anavar for the first time and you were like my size, you'd wake up in 3 days and you'd be like a fucking washboard. Because I'm naturally shredded, so yeah. But no, I don't compete because I've seen what you need to do to compete, and I refuse to go on all those diets and shit. I do not count calories. I don't count this. I don't count shit. I work out like five hours a day, and I basically, anything that I put into my body, I basically work out not double but close to it, so I just naturally get rid of everything. So there's no fat on me because I go. If that's the best way. Like, I don't even do cardio. Because, like, right now I'm soaked, and I'm only doing biceps, and I'm soaked. And I'm not even jumping around. I didn't do any, like, my warm-up is doing light weights. And if anybody's wondering, 44 years old, and I'm 6'1". And I believe, as of now, I'm 160 pounds. I have been working on my chest very, very isolatingly for the past 2 months, so I really appreciate that, and I'm trying to work it more. My biceps I kind of have, but my chest I'm really working on, so I appreciate that. But yeah, I do abs and stuff too, so any other questions, let me know. I am happy to answer them. The music you'll be listening to is copyright-free music by Trade Secrets Music, found on YouTube. And if anybody's wondering, I am watching The Real Kipper and Bourne. It is basically this hockey review from the night before. That's what I'm watching on YouTube. Oh, and the Leafs won. Oh my God. We'll be right back. What is love? But you don't really do chest for a certain amount of time. Like, I've been doing this for 15 to 20 years, but like I haven't been doing it seriously until honestly the pandemic started, because I was like, I had a home gym, I was doing tons of Instagram stuff, but I didn't really do any streaming because I really didn't even think about it, to be honest, because Twitch to me was like gaming and YouTube was just like, there's no chance because there's so many fitness people out there, it's just insane. So I started doing this probably when the pandemic started, because I love to chat with people. I don't love to be around a ton of people, but I do enjoy chatting about fitness and this and that and the other thing. So it's not me talking to like people, it's me talking to a cam, so it's a lot easier. But I'm a very social person, and there's so much negativity that was going on during the pandemic that I couldn't deal with it. And I'm like, fuck this, I'm gonna sit down in my basement, I'm gonna put on Netflix or Spotify, and I'm just gonna train and say fuck you to the drama and fuck you to politics. And it's wonderful. So I've been going hard on my chest, I would say probably for a little over a year. Like, I've been training, but not really seriously training. And now I'm like, I wanna try and get to 170 pounds, not of like, rah, but I want to be like a solid 170, which is about 10 more pounds, and then that's it, and then lean it out a bit. So I also found out that I gained a lot more definition, meaning you can see the angles, that, like, you know, Brooklyn Nine-Nine, the titty bounce, one and two, and one and two, and one and two, like, tear titties. When you see the peaks, or the pecs, I do a lot more dumbbells now. I just smashed my desktop. What you gonna do? I started doing more dumbbells and really isolating my chest. Instead of doing flat bar, I was doing dumbbells, because I got away from the gym due to the pandemic and the health problems and the health issues. Like, you have to wipe everything down. Gyms are dirty as hell. So I started doing dumbbells because I didn't have access, or I started doing the flat bar because I didn't have access to cable machines. And then my chest got a little bigger. And then the last year I started doing dumbbells, thinking like, well, a cable machine I don't have, but in order to get that different type of motion and like the tightness, and so you can actually like make the pec go into detail, that is what you need with dumbbells, because the dumbbells basically work as cables. So I'm doing that. And I also started going back to the gym, and I'm probably gonna get a membership in the next week or two after I do enough drop-ins. So my chest is really starting to build up now. So I'm isolating my chest more. So it's not like dumbbells, or like chest one day, legs one day, biceps the next day. So it's like chest three times a week, back and biceps or whatever twice, because I know my biceps are good, but my chest I really need to work on. So my legs are toothpicks. They got power, but they're not impressive. That's why the board shorts. TJ's got toothpicks. So any other questions, comments, let me know. I'm just going to turn the music up, but I have the mic on. Hopefully I don't swear. Thank you. Oh yeah, Friday. It's Friday. Like for most people that have been following me for a while, I actually have a half rack. It's like a squat rack that I used to use for flat, but flat bar wasn't really working the pecs for me. It was working like up top in general, but it wasn't focusing in on stuff. So when I want to work the pec, my arms have to go like this. So doing the EC curl does work to a certain degree, but doing dumbbells, you can just totally angle your hand and tighten your band up. So I actually took my half rack completely apart and put it in the storage behind the wall. I did that about 2 weeks ago and I've already seen better results. It's like instant results. It's like, oh, this is a new technique. Welcome to the world. Mr. McQueen. I actually stopped. I ever used to be a really good show in CW. Stopped watching it because when they had a goalie come out as a superhero, I was like, come out. Anybody watching Mr. Mercedes on Prime? That's an eye-opener. I don't think I've ever been shocked in any show, every single episode, like 3 times an episode in my life. If you guys can handle suspense and very insane thriller and almost horror, watch that. It's next level. Thank you. We're gonna do two more sets of isolation, and then we're gonna do double arm, single dumbbell isolation curls. Working on that peak. I'd love to play better music, but Twitch will ding my ass DMCA, so I can't.
Sorry.
And I've tried Prime Music Extension, and almost all the good songs are locked, and you have to pay for unlimited, which I'm not doing, so. Oh, and for anybody that is into the NHL drama, the Boston Bruins have just signed a goalie to a 3-year deal for $700,000, who went on a racist tirade and also forced a mentally challenged kid when he was 14 to lick a urinal. But we have to move past that because people apologized. Welcome to the NHL, where everything's swept under the rug. So we'll do about four sets of these, and then we're going to do some abs to end off the stream.
Yes.
Also, all of my streams are recorded, and they are on my YouTube channel. And it will be a later stream tomorrow again, because I am going to visit fam.
Google? Because the lights right there. Oh yeah, just when I got into the group, it's like, no. And I still do. Thank you. Cap's so hot right now. New indoor shoes, $10 Walmarts.
Oh, yeah.
When the burn doesn't go away for like 30 seconds, you know you're getting all those muscles. One of the best things I ever bought for like 10 bucks, I think, foam roller. You get them at Walmart. They're great for cracking your back and just rolling up those muscles. Body weight. So we're doing two more sets of abs and then we're done.
Hello. Alrighty, that is it for today. I appreciate the views, I appreciate the chat, I appreciate the follow, I appreciate the subs. Keep it on your end, I'll keep it on my end. Beautiful relationship with none of the drama. Till tomorrow, which will be a little bit later because I'm going to visit fam. Lift heavy, lift strong, most of all lift, and be safe. TJ out.